Hello and welcome to part one of a series of tutorials on using Zotero at RIT. I am your presenter, Roman Kashikar, one of the reference and instruction librarians at RIT. Please note that you can always refer to the RIT Library's info guide on Zotero for support on using this citation management system. Zotero is a free, open-source program that will help you organize information that you find online and write better academic papers by inserting properly formatted citations and bibliographies. Zotero can be used by any academic writer to support their research and writing, from undergraduate students to graduate students enrolled in master's or doctoral programs to faculty researchers engaged in publication of advanced research. To get started using Zotero, simply download and install a few free programs on your computer. You do not need to use your RIT credentials. Zotero can be downloaded by anyone directly from their website. Follow the links from the Install Zotero page on the guide or simply visit zotero.org directly. Here's the download page on Zotero's website. I'm using a Windows computer for my demonstration, so the download page directs me to install Zotero for Windows. I have already installed Zotero, so in the interest of time, I will not demonstrate the installation process. Please note that Zotero also offers desktop clients for macOS and Linux, providing you the flexibility to work on any operating system. You should also install the Zotero browser connector. Momentarily, I'll demonstrate how useful the browser connector is in building your library of references and documents. Connectors are available for Chrome, Firefox, Safari, and Edge, providing you with the flexibility to work in the browser of your choice. I also recommend that you register for a free account with Zotero. Follow the register link and fill out the registration form. There are several features of Zotero that become available for you when you sign in with your account, namely syncing your library of references for online access from the cloud and collaborating with other Zotero users by creating and using Zotero groups. Once again, in the interest of time, I won't demonstrate the registration process, but if I log in with my own account, you'll see that I can view my saved library of references by selecting Web Library. Zotero provides all users with 300 megabytes of free storage on their server. You can manage this storage by selecting Upgrade Storage. Larger storage limits can be purchased for reasonable annual rates, one of the few features Zotero ever charges money for. Now I will launch Zotero from my desktop. The Zotero interface is quite simple, with a directory on the left of my collections of references, a central panel listing all items saved in my library, and a detail view panel on the right where I can see the data elements of an individual item I select. I have many saved items, but as a new user, your Zotero library will be empty at first. Next, I will show you a few simple methods for building up a library of references from online searches. The most common method is to use the browser connector, which changes in context when Zotero sees a reference data embedded in a web page. The Zotero browser connector translates this information and saves the data to a record in your library. I'll demonstrate this by searching for a book in the RIT library catalog. Note how the browser connector now resembles the cover of a book. If I click this, all bibliographic information that would go into a citation in my writing is saved to Zotero in my Zotero library. It's simple and automatic. But you may want to review the saved information in Zotero's detail view to make any edits or updates that may be needed. You can also save multiple references from a search by using the Zotero browser connector. I'll demonstrate this by searching Google Scholar. Note the browser connector now resembles a file folder. If I click this, Zotero allows me to check the search results that I want to save. Simply click OK and the connector saves all of your selected items to your Zotero library. Once again, you may want to review the saved information for accuracy and update it as needed. One of the most useful features of Zotero is invoked when you save a PDF of an article. In Zotero's terminology, it will retrieve metadata from a PDF, which means that all the bibliographic reference information will automatically populate a new Zotero record when you add a PDF of an article. If you already have a saved PDF on your computer, you can simply drag and drop it into the center panel of Zotero. And just like that, the reference metadata is entered into a new record. The PDF stays in Zotero as an attachment. Zotero uses Crossref to look up the reference metadata, so this feature will work only if Crossref has registered metadata for the article. This concludes the Build Your Library module of this tutorial series. In the next module, I will demonstrate organizing and syncing your Zotero library and collaborating with other Zotero users.